beta, because when a patient is being operated, a surgical process is going on and the patient is there on the table, you anesthetize the patient. You do not give the freedom to walk to the patient. You do not give the freedom to talk to the patient. Do you understand this? There are situations where your speaking will be extremely harmful for yourself. A patient is being operated on the table, and what if he starts walking and talking and saying, "This is my right, my freedom. How can you take away my freedom to speak, my freedom to walk?" When I entered, let me give you an example. My friend here, what's your name? Now, little Nidhi, when I entered here, she made quite a nice face looking at me. She was delighted to look at me, actually. So delighted that she quickly picked her bag and ran. It's okay, yaar, we are friends. Now, had I given her the right to run away, could she have enjoyed this session?
Sir, this is again imposing something upon us.
Ask her, aren't you glad that you are here right now? Ask her. Beta, there are situations where you do not know what is good for you. Only later on you will come and say thank you. Only later on will you come and say thank you. Thank you that you did not allow me to run away. Thank you for applying a little bit of force on me. Because I anyway do not understand any language except force. Do you understand any language except that of force? If attendance compulsion is not there, how many subjects will you attend? Huh? If the temptation of job is not there, how many of you will complete B.Tech? If that temptation of future is not there, will you study for your love? So you work only through two engines, which are the same, greed and fear. Remove greed, remove fear, you will not move at all. So even to liberate you, a little bit of force is to be used. Even to set, it's a very peculiar situation. Even to set you free, somebody has to apply a little bit of force. Otherwise, Nidhi wouldn't have been here. She would have been in 237. And now she's glad that she's here. What to do, Rishabh? That's our strange situation. We actually need somebody to pull our ears. Huh? It's unfortunate, but that's what we have come to. I desperately want that you come to a situation where nobody needs to pull your ears. And I'm pulling your ears so that you can come to that situation. You have to, see, you have to then look at what is happening to you. By pulling your ears, are you becoming free or are you becoming further bonded? You have to look at it yourself with your open eyes. If I have stopped you here, am I making you feel small or am I making you feel free? You have to look at that. Yes, there is no doubt that I used a little bit of force in stopping you here. But after that, how have you felt? Small, bonded, or free? You have to ask yourself.